We're here for you. Like the woman with the alabaster box, we want our worship to rise like a sweet perfume as we pour our love all over it. Come on, Toronto, help me sing it out. From here to there, worship is filling the atmosphere, both now and then. Songs of your love will never end. Sing all day and night, as we bow down, inside and out.
And this is eternal life, that we would know him, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom he has sent. And so, Father, we look to you now as the one who is our source.
Starts on the four.
The one who is our strength.
Starts on the four.
The one who is our redemption. The one who is our salvation. The one who is our deliverance. You don't just deliver, you are deliverance. You don't just save, you are Savior. You don't just redeem, you are redemption. In you is everything that we need. You are wisdom, you are righteousness, you are power, you are glory, you are excellence. We thank you and we honor you, great King. So take a moment and set your eyes on the one who sits on the throne. Come on, those in this room and those at home, come on, set your eyes on the one who reigns. Set your eyes on the one who doesn't just have the answer, he is the answer. Come on. Come on, this is how we're worshiping tonight. We're staring at him. Come on. Come on, we're looking at Jesus. We're looking at the one who bled and died. Come on, can you see the nail prints in his hand? Come on, that's his love. Can you see the nail prints in his feet? That's his love. Come on, can you see the blood that stains his robe? Come on, that's his love. That's his love. That's what he thinks about you. That's how he cares for you. And I want you to know that the King of Glory, the King of Kings, who is exalted in the heavens, is right here in this room. He's right there in your home where two or three are gathered in his name. He's right there in the midst. Come on, can you look at the person next to you and say, he's right here. He's right here. Come on, you don't have to look far. He's right here.
Here.
The King of Kings is in this room.
One, two,
we worship you.
First, two, three, four.
The King of Kings is in this room. We bow down and worship you. The King of Kings is in this room. Be enthroned in
four.
Our praises. The King of Kings is in this room. We bow down and worship you. King of Kings, be enthroned in our praises. Yeah, the King of Kings, right here in full. Oh, we honor Jesus. Be enthroned in our
praises.
Forever you are king. Just see. Perceive that he is everything. Because as righteous as we would like to be, many of us struggle with surrender, not because we don't want to do it, but because we don't trust that God will fill every void left by what we give up. For some, it's a sin issue, but for some of us, we got to give up control. Some of us got to give up being in control. Others of us have to give up looking like we got it in control. But I can only give you everything when I see that you are everything. I can only give you everything when I see that you are everything. You're everything. You're everything. Ooh. You are my king. My everything. You are the way when there is no way. My everything. You are my peace in the middle of the storm. My everything. And in your presence there is fullness of joy. At your right hand pleasures forevermore. Everything. You give me joy unspeakable and full of glory. You are everything. Jesus, my everything. Come on, somebody, love on your Savior. Somebody, love on your God. Everything. Found you to be. Found you to be everything.
Over there yet.
So that's why I surrender all.
Just be by myself.
That's why I.
On that
surrender
all
to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender everything. You are my everything. everything. One more time, we're moving. Oh, I surrender all. Come on, from your spirit. I want to say that again, because you're really saying that in faith. Say, I surrender. Come on, because we may not even know all we got to surrender, but still, God, I'm saying yes to what you haven't even shown me yet. Because I've counted the cost and I found you to be worth it all. Oh, the excellency of the knowledge of you, I surrender. It's worth everything just to know you. Just to know you, Jesus. Come on, let's go say, all to thee, my blessed.
Just a few more seconds, lift your voice in worship. I know clapping is a form that we use, but lift your voice in worship. Lift your voice in worship. Clapping is good and it's okay, but let them hear your voice. Let them hear your voice. Let them hear your voice. You made a declaration that He is your everything. Now just take 30 seconds and talk more to Him. Father, we thank you for this moment. Thank you for your presence that's in this place. Thank you for who you are and who you are to us, being our everything. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. Can we just sing that chorus that I surrender all? Can we just sing it together? Everybody, let's sing. Lifted hands, all to thee,
all to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender.
If that's your prayer tonight, clap your hands and bless them. Come on, clap your hands and bless them. Somebody give God praise for our amazing worship team. Elder Jeffrey Golden leading us. Come on, clap your hands and bless Him, bless Him, bless Him, bless Him. This is the day that the Lord our God has made. Anybody excited to be in His house? Anybody making a decision to rejoice? I said, is anybody making a decision to rejoice and be glad in it? Tell your neighbor, I made a decision to be here. And because I'm here, I'm going to rejoice. I made a decision to come tonight, and because I'm here, I'm going to rejoice. I'm going to rejoice. I'm going to rejoice. Now show your rope what it looks like to rejoice in making a decision to lift up the name of Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. If you haven't already, why don't you greet your
straight
neighbor?
Straight narrow, brother Mike. Don't you turn.
Yeah. Come on, show them some love. Show them some real Potter's House love.
There you go.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is great, is He not? I said, God is good, is He not? I'm excited to be with you all on tonight. I'm Pastor Oscar Williams, and I'm facilitating. And I don't have a lot of announcements, just really one. Coming to remind us that the ILS Summit, the International Leadership Summit, is fastly approaching. Oh, somebody else ought to clap for that. It is not too late. It is March the 21st through the 23rd right here in sunny Dallas. And I say sunny Dallas because if you're not here, y'all give our online viewers a hand. Our e-church family, we're so glad that you're tuned in. We're enjoying like 65 degree weather, and I'm thanking God for it's middle of February. It's supposed to be 70 next week, so that's a good indication. Thank you, Father. Somebody ought to get excited. That's a good indication that you need to meet us here for the International Leadership Summit, March 21st through the 23rd. Our theme is timing is everything. It's your turn, it's your time. The conference is unique not only because it's founded in faith, but also because it is the intersection of faith and marketplace. This is a space for all spiritual and business leaders alike to gain insight, tangible and practical tools for success, and an opportunity to network with the best. If you have not booked your hotel room, please do so through the ILS website to receive our discount. Everybody say discount. Okay, you want to go to the website and book your rooms. Rooms are going fast. Some have already been sold out, so don't wait. You can head to thisisils.org to register and book your room today, as well as the conference. Now, I'm going to go off script and say this. I've been at the church for about 13, 14 years. And I remember when I first got here going to what was then called the International Pastors and Leadership Conference that has now evolved to the ILS International Leadership Summit. And I, as a member of this church, one of the things that helped me get acclimated really well is being a part of our conference. Now, I know you hear people coming and you see people coming from all over the world, but this is our conference. Tell your neighbor, this is ours. Say it with conviction. Tell them, this is ours. And being a new member of a big church, and a lot of times being in a big church, sometimes you can get, you know, kind of lost in all of what's going on. And I came to the International Pastors and Leader Conference, and don't get, this is, I'm going to say this, I love our security team, but I used to always think our security team was me. Because, you know, they don't smile a lot. You know, and you know, and you walk up to them and you know, it's, but they're doing their job. And so I went to the conference. I say all that. Now listen to the completion of the story. So I go to the IPNL conference and I walk in and I'm like, man, I'm a new member. I want to get to know. I want to get involved. I just don't know where I fit. And I was walking along one of the security persons and he said, man, my feet hurt. I said, man, my feet hurt too. And we laughed and had a moment. And I realized that, wait a minute, you all right? You ain't, you. And we developed a bond and I started to meet more of my fellow church members that are working as the PMTs and working in the registration. And it was a way for me to get involved and meet my church. So I say all that to say, when you hear us make announcements about the International Leadership Summit, don't think about it as something for somebody else. This is our conference. Tell somebody, this is ours. And if you're looking for a way to get involved, if you're looking for a way to meet your fellow church members, if you're looking for a way to understand more about the place that you serve in, the place that you come to, you need to make sure that you're at our ILS Summit. It's right here in Dallas, so you don't have to get a plane ticket. It is convenient just for you, and you will see your church in such a different way. Somebody clap your hands and praise God. Keep those hands going because it's offering time in the temple. If you are new here, you're wondering why they're getting excited because of offering, because we understand that there is a blessing in sowing. We are excited because this is our opportunity to see the ground grow up and render to us what we have sowed as good seeds in the ground. This is our time to get excited because we know that God only expects a cheerful giver to be cheerful because he gave us something to give. The reason why I give is because I understand that the law of reciprocity is an earth principle. It's not just a biblical principle, but it's an earth principle. If you plant something and you water what you planted, it will grow. So if I plant seed in the ground, I can expect a harvest because I planted something. It is the law that God put into the earth. And so when it comes time for tithes and offering, I'm excited because I understand every time I plant into the ground, some harvest is coming up. Anybody need harvest? And not just money harvest. I know when I plant, I'm expecting God to bring harvest in my body for healing, harvest in my business, harvest for the people around me, harvest not just for me, but for my family. How many can stand for your family to be blessed? And so I'm going to ask you one more time. Anybody excited about giving tonight? Anybody excited about planting? It's a good ground to receive your harvest. Our PMTs, which are our professional ministry technicians, are in the aisles. They have envelopes. You can choose to give by traditional methods, or most of us give on our phone. I'm giving on my phone tonight. I'm excited. I brought my phone up with me to give because I cannot wait to sow into good ground. This is good soil. This is good soil. And sowing into this ground, I'm expecting God to remember my seed and to bless what it is that I sow. The praise team is coming to give us a song, and I'll come back and pray over our gifts.
Here we go. Did you hear? 3 and
Scripture says, your word have I hidden in my heart, that I may not sin against you. That's what we're doing tonight. We're taking his word.
I know. You don't believe me out there, though. I trust you not.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to the Father.
That's it. Let him come.
Except that he comes through me.
Black tongues.
So let my mercy
have the orange one.
Right
on the tablet, on the tablet of your heart.
Yo.
Let God be true and every man a liar. Write his word on the tablet of your heart. As we get ready for the word, come on, say that one time. Come on, write them on. Come on, say, write them on the tablet.
Let's sing it up there.
Your word is a lamp to my path.
One more time.
Come on, let's stand with our gifts. I feel God in this place. I feel God in this place. Do me a favor and lift up that gift. We lift it up with our right hand because it's symbolic. We don't put it in our left hand because we don't want to give God what's left. We want to give him what's right. We lift it up. Lift up your gift high, high. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you with this seed of sacrifice. Not just what's in my hand, but Father, the sacrifice of my heart. Because God, I am a part of this seed. Everything a part of me, Father, is being sold into the kingdom. I sow not only what's in my hand, but I sow myself. I sow my life. I sow my gifts. I sow my talents, Father God. God, this gift I give to you, Father, I am believing that you see, God, not just what's in my hand, but what's in my heart. It's not about the amount, Father God, but it's about the intent in which I am giving. Now bless this, Father. Bless it 100-fold. 1,000-fold, 1,000,000-fold, Father. My faith is not too small to believe that you can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that I can ask or even think. And so right now, Father, I sow with expectation because I know that you're God, that you cannot lie, neither the Son of Man that you should repent. If you spoke it, you will bring it to pass. And this seed is blessed, and I sow it with a cheerful heart. In the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. Somebody shout out, amen. Come on, pass your offering to your left. Pass your offering to your left. Pass that piece of paper to your left. To your left. And we don't give in silence. We give with a praise. We give with a praise. We give with a praise. Come on, praise as you see that seed traveling. Come on, I said praise with expectation as you see that seed getting ready to be sold. PMT, serve the people of God. While they're serving, come on, you praise. While they're serving, you praise. We're getting ready to go to the word, but as you stand and as we get ready to dive into what God is saying to us, we would be remiss if we would honor our senior leaders in their absence. Come on, give God praise for Bishop T.D. Jakes and First Lady Sarita Jakes. Come on, we get a little more excited about our leadership here. Come on, while you're clapping, let's give God praise for our assistant pastors, Pastor Torrey Roberts, Pastor Sarah Jakes Roberts, and all of our associate pastors. Like come that? On, come on, come on. And for you, my father's children, I give God praise for you being here. I believe the Lord is going to speak to us tonight. I believe the Lord is going to say something to us tonight. And we're going to look in Ephesians if you have your Bible. If not, don't worry about it. It'll be on the screen. You can read alone. It is our custom here to stand for the reading of the Word of God. We're in Ephesians. We're going to start in chapter 1, verses 15 through 23, and then we're going to go just to chapter 2 for a few verses, 1 through 7.
You take
Ephesians 1.
Yeah.
Started at verse 15 through 23.